I'm setting the story up so you can understand where I'm going. I'll never forget when I get to her house to pick up her and her son to move in with me. Her mom came out and her mom told me she is not the one for me. She's going to lie to me and she's going to steal from me. This is her own mother. She says, I love my daughter, but she is not the one for you. She's going to lie to you and she's going to steal from me, Anthony. And I was like, no way. She hasn't lied to me and she hasn't stolen anything from me. Mama, you crazy. And I thought mama was just trying to stop us from moving in together because mama was a very strong spiritual woman, you know, and just like my parents, just very strong. Don't believe in shacking up. Don't believe in living together. And I get it. But I was like, I'm a grown man. You know, I'm about to be 21. And so I moved her in. And, you know, some of y'all call it toxic. That was just a toxic relationship. And we had a very interesting relationship. A lot of arguing. A lot of cussing each other out. Y'all, even to the point where this young lady even cussed out my own mom. My own mother. And I still went back to her. I still stayed with her. Even to the point to where she cheated on me several times. And I caught her with her son's father. And so making a long story short with that, I got tired of it. And we got into a very bad argument. Nothing physical, nothing like that, but just a very heated, very bad argument. And she left. I kicked her out the house. You know, at that time in my life, that was right around the time that I was working hard to pay off my debt, right? And about 3 or 4 months later, I started just noticing that my account balances would be a little low. And I was like, dang, man, did I spend that much money? And I was like, whoa, okay. And I never really noticed it because you know why? I didn't have things in place. I didn't have a budget in place. I wasn't monitoring my bank account. I was just swiping my money. I would get paid. I'll go pay off this debt. I'll go out here with some friends and chill. But I didn't really have a system put in place. Now, mind you, my father gave me a budget form when I first got out of being homeless, right? But I didn't really stick to it. And I was playing around in areas. I didn't really have a plan that I was following at that particular time. And so I got this large commission check. I want to say it was about, when I think about it now, yeah, it was about like $2,000. And when I got the check for $2,000, whew, I'm excited. I'm like, yo, I got another $2,000 account. Boom, I'm about to go pay off this. I'm about to go out here with my friends, get some, you know, that's where I think it was back then, like 2 for $10, get 2 drinks for $10. Let me just go out here and chill with my people. So I go to the bank because back then, how many of y'all remember this? CJ, how many of y'all remember getting the physical check? Back then, it really wasn't direct deposits. It was you got the physical check right before lunch. Then you can go to the bank to deposit your check. So I got that deposit. Not the deposit, I got the check. Boom. I went over to the bank to deposit it. I'm like, yeah, you can't tell me nothing. Woo! I get to the bank. I deposit this check. I deposit like $2,000. She gives me my receipt. She says, your available balance is $700. Hey, ma'am, you must have gave me the wrong receipt. She was like, whoa, what you mean? I was like, no. You gave me the wrong receipt. She was like, no, son, you gave me this, and this is what I gave you. This is your receipt. I said, ma'am, I gave you $2,000. You're telling me my available balance is $700 and something. No, ma'am. That doesn't make sense. She said, no, son, it does make sense. You were overdrawn. And I was like, I was not in the negative. What are you talking about? No. Y'all, mind you, just about like earlier that week, I checked the account because I was going out here to get some gas. I was, you know, I didn't check my budget. I just checked my account. I got money in the account. Boom, great. And actually back then, you didn't check it. You called the number. How many of y'all remember calling a number and to hear the voice? Your available balance is da-da-da-da-da. You know, back then we didn't have the really online just yet. We called the back of the car, type in your da-da-da-da-da-da. Your available balance is this. Okay. And back then, the available balance didn't have pending in it. It didn't say your available balance is $322 and pending transactions are da da da. No, they just told you available. Pending was not in that. So really, that wasn't what was available. So me and the lady going back and forth. And I say, ma'am, I need an explanation. I don't understand what you're saying. Like, I have not spent more money than what I've had in my bank account. And I'll be honest with you all, back then, I really wasn't. Like, I really was looking at that what's pending, and then I would minus that from what's my available rate. And so I was very mindful of that because I didn't want to go to negative. I was already in check systems about a year before that because of all the negative debt that I had. I had just got my name cleared out of check systems, so I didn't want to go back into check systems. Some of y'all probably know what I mean by check systems. You know, check system was if you owed the bank money, check system was if you was always writing negative checks and they were bouncing, they would put you in check systems where you could not open up a checking account because you would either overdraw your account and leave it in negative and you end up owing the bank money from your checking account. So I had just got my name clear from check systems. I'm like, y'all, I'm not doing that. So you guys, she prints off this loan sheet and this is very important for y'all to hear this. She prints off my bank statements, the same statements that if I would have went online, I could have saw for myself. And she showed me that over the last 3 or 4 months, there are payments of like $200. There are payments of like $400. Even one of them was up to a $700. And they're all from a hair store. And I'm sitting here like, a hair store? The first thought that came to my head was my barber. Was like, whoa. My hair only costs $20 to get a haircut. And back then, can I be real? I'm going to put myself out there. Can I be real? Back then, yeah, I was doing the Beijing. You know what I'm saying? I was doing the Beijing where they put that little black stuff all in your hair, let it sit there. It's like, and I was doing that. And that was about like $50. But it wasn't $250. It was not $700. I'm like, yo, what is my barber doing? Like, what was he doing all this time? And then it hit me. I wasn't giving him my debit card. I was paying cash. So I called my barber to see, like, yo, bro, you robbing from me? He's like, yo, bro, I don't know what you're talking about. That's not me. That's not the name of my company. And so the lady had gave me the name and the number of the company that was on the account. She said, hey, son, go do your research. And if this is fraud, if you did not purchase this, then come back to the bank and we can do a dispute. And I was like, a dispute? She was like, yeah, and that dispute can take about 14 to 30 days, depending on the dispute. But we can give you a provisional credit. And I was like, a provisional credit? She said, yes, a provisional credit simply means that we will put it there. We'll put the money back in your account temporarily while we're doing the case. And the money will stay there if we come back and find out it was fraud. Or if it wasn't fraud, we pull the money back. So I said, ma'am, file a dispute. I filed a dispute. I remember signing all these pieces of paper. It took them about like 72 days to put the provisional credit in my account. Throughout the 72 days, I started doing my own research. And you guys, I'm going to be real with you. I was hurt. I was emotional because after doing my own investigation, I found out that this was the hair store that my ex at the time, right before that, was going to get her hair. And so when we broke up, I had thought that I lost my debit card, but I totally forgot that I had gave her my debit card to put some gas in her tank the day before we broke up. She just never gave it back to me because sometimes we'll always go out to dinner together with me, her, and her son. And I'll go, babe, you got my card? She'll, yeah, she'll give me my card back, but I never got the card back. And I honestly thought I just lost it. To only find out I didn't lose it, she kept it. And she was purchasing hair. Weave, wigs, with my information. And I didn't have nothing in place to alert me, to let me know, hey, this is happening. I didn't have nothing in place to let me know that someone is charging my card. Someone has stolen my identity. And y'all, it hurt, one, because it was someone who I honestly invited into my home. It was someone that I invited her and her son into my home that I was loving. It was rough. And y'all, it took about a whole month and a half to get that credit with the bank. I'll be honest. I got the provisional credit, stayed on my account. I was able to prove that it wasn't mine. And, you know, since then, I've been very, 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 as much as I possibly can, just watchful and putting things into place to protect myself. And I know you're probably thinking, like, Anthony, well, why are you telling us this story? Because identity theft is real. And it's a lot more common than you think. And I wrote down some notes because I'm starting to write down more notes as I do these shows, because I want to make sure that I'm giving y'all, one, practical information and giving you the correct stats and making sure that I'm not all over the place. Because as a preacher, y'all know I can go all over the place. But identity theft is real. Every 6 seconds, there is a victim of identity theft in the United States. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Someone's identity was just stolen. And here's the truth, it's only getting worse. You see, identity theft has doubled from 2019 to 2021. And in fact, Americans lost $5.9 billion to fraud last year. These are regular people like you and like myself. We're not talking about millionaires. We're not talking about billionaires. We're not talking about celebrities. We're talking about people like you, like your spouse, like your kids, like your loved ones, like myself, who have lost their identity to someone else because they didn't have things put into place to protect themselves. And at this point, there's this interesting stat that says you're more likely to have your identity stolen than your own car. And I've had my car stolen. So if we don't have things put into place to protect us, if you're working hard to get out of debt and to build wealth for your future, if you're working hard to build wealth, to start a business so you can live life and enjoy life and do the things you want to do with your family, if you're getting up every single day, taking your kids to school, going to work as a single mother, coming back home, getting your kids situated with homework and cooking dinner and dating and being a family person, if you're working hard Monday through Friday, putting in all this hard labor for someone else to steal the fruit of your labor, for someone else to sit here, let you go do all this work, let you go put in all this time for them to sit behind their computer, for them to be close to you like a friend, smile in your face, be on the computer stealing your stuff. She's working. He's working. Oh yeah, let me get this. Let me steal her. Let me steal his identity. Let me do this. Nah. Mm-mm. It's time for you to protect yourself and your loved ones with the right identity theft protection. It can save you countless of dollars, thousands of dollars. And you know what? And even time. Time. Because I remember I couldn't sleep for a couple of days. Because I was going through this whole identity situation. And identity theft protection, I personally trust, is Aura. It is Aura. Aura is honestly the very best identity theft protection out there.